Hello, this is Travis Sabin from Adobe Analytics Product Management, and today I'm going to be walking you through a new inline segmentation tool called the Quick Segment Builder. So the Quick Segment Builder is a new segmentation option here within the panel header in Analysis Workspace. So we've added this filter icon here at the top. If you click on that, it will open up a builder here at the top of the panel with some simplified segmentation options for you. So to start, you can include or exclude all of these rules that you're going to be building here, and you can base it off of a hit, visit, or visitor level. And then you can mix and match up to three dimensions, metrics, or date ranges to define this segment that you're building. So I can drag and drop. I can use the dropdown. I can type search to build out these rules. And let's say for this case, I'm going to do the UK. Edit that. We'll change it to the US. So let's say for this use case, I'm going to do the United States. And so now I've got a rule where I'm including all hits that originated from the United States. Up here in the top, I've got a little preview to let me know what kind of data I'm getting. So it's green with a little check mark indicating there is data and showing that 99% of my hits came from the United States. And like I said, you can add up to three rules, so you can either drag and drop directly on here, you can click the plus, and you can build from here. So if I wanted to a date range, I need to change this, and then I could change this to be the last 30 days. And now I have segment definition where my countries are the United States and they have at least, or is equals one visit, let's say greater than or equal to within the last 30 days. Now I can change this so I can OR these together, so they have to just meet one of these criteria. And then if I feel like I'm ready with my definition, I click apply. Now applying it adds a new pill here at the top. Some things to note here, the coloration here is slightly different than our regular segmentation colors. It's the same blue, but it's a lighter opacity. And we've labeled it as a quick segment across the top versus just a standard segment. And if I hover, I have an edit pencil that'll open up the quick segment builder with all my rules, or a preview to show me some of the data previews that we see with our regular segments. But if I want to come in and edit this segment, then I pop it back open. And let's say I wanted to remove some of these rules. So I can either remove a specific pill by clicking on the X on the inside, or if I want to get rid of this whole line of rules entirely, I click the X on the outside and it automatically bumps the other rules up. Let's say I don't want this one either. We'll keep it simple. And so now I've got my simple segment of users who are coming from the United States. So once I hit apply, then again, it'll apply and filter my data within the project, and I'm off and running. So a couple of other things to note here. When you're building a segment, if you run into a case where there isn't any data, it'll be red with a little warning. And if you want to still continue because you're expecting data to come at a later date or your date range just needs to change, you can still continue. You hit apply, it'll give you a little warning, and then you can continue anyways. And then you can change the name here. Right now we're giving it a default name, but you can come in and make this something else if you want to change it to users, if you want to append something, or if you want to delete the whole thing and say my US customer, and then today I'll just call it a test, my US customer test, and I can apply that. And now let's say I've decided that, you know, I'm building this segment, it's been helpful, but I want to do something more complicated. Well, you can take this segment and you need something, if you want something more than three rules, or you need multiple containers, you can open it in the full segment builder. Before doing so, we give you a little warning to let you know, if you apply or save the segment in the full segment builder, you won't be able to come back and edit it here in the quick segment builder. So if you come in here, your rules are automatically applied, but let's say I did this by mistake and you cancel, you can come back, your rules are retained, you can still apply it, use it here in the quick segment builder, no problem. But if you intended to do something in the builder and you wanted to make this a more complicated segment, you can apply it. And right now we have this new project only segment dialog box here at the top. Previously, this was our little make public checkbox at the bottom. We've tried to make this a little bit more visible and understandable for what it will do. Right now, because it's not checked, this is staying in this project only, and it is not added to my component list. And so right now, I'm just applying it to this project. When I do so, it changes it. So now it is no longer a quick segment. I can't edit. There's no more edit pencil to open the quick segment builder. I'd have to open here and click the edit pencil here. And the color is now the regular blue, and it says segment across the top. So let's say I wanted to actually make this a segment that is available elsewhere beyond this project, and I wanted to add it to my component list. Well, I simply just checked this box and I hit save, and now it's added to the top of my segment list. Another way to do that is, let's build a quick segment right here. Let's say I had visits. Don't have any data apparently, but I want to continue anyways. And let's say I wanted to, instead of having to go through that workflow of opening the builder, clicking the checkbox, I just wanted to make it into a real segment out the gate because I know I need it elsewhere. You can click on the info icon, and this is similar to what we had before, but we've changed the language again to make it more clear what's happening. You simply would hit this make available, and it would add it to your list and make it available to all your projects throughout Analysis Workspace. Now, there's no limit to the number of quick segments that you can build. You can have a whole bunch of these, depending on what you're wanting to do. So you can add as many quick segments to the top of your panel as much as you want. So let's make another one. Right now, my data was still being validated, so I got a warning because I was a little too fast. You can see underneath, my data did validate, but I was a little quicker than that. So now I've got multiple quick segments up here. So that is the quick segment builder. Again, this is meant for simple segmentation on the fly within this workflow without having to leave Analysis Workspace, building some of these basic segment rules that you might need a little bit faster and quicker than you normally would. So thank you for your time.